Okay, so in this problem, we are given n balloons, which are indexed from 0 to n minus 1, and each balloon is painted with a number on it. And if we burst the ith balloon, we get the points num of I minus 1 multiplied by num of I multiplied by num of I plus 1. Okay, so basically any balloon we pop, we are going to multiply the points from that balloon's number multiplied by the adjacent balloons. Okay, so what we have to do is return the maximum coins we can collect by bursting the balloons wisely. So we have to maximize the amount of coins which we can collect by bursting the balloons wisely. Okay, so the input says nums equals 3158 and it gives 167. Okay, so let's try to do a dry run for this input and see how we can get 167 by running through hands. Okay, if we see here, we have the array 3, 1, 5, and 8. So now, for the simplicity, if you see on the edge cases, we have one extra balloon which have the number 1 on them. So now, if I burst this balloon, I get 3 points, which is the multiplication of these 3 numbers. So 3 from this guy. If I burst this balloon, then I get 15 from this pair. If I burst this balloon, then I get 40 from this pair. And if I burst 8, then also I get 40 from this pair. So 40. So now after in this array 3, 1, 5, 8, when we picked 3, so we had, let's say we picked 3, so we had the answer 3 plus whatever the answer we get from 1, 5, and 8. Okay. If we pick points equals, if we pick 1, then we get 15 plus whatever we get from the remaining elements in the array, which is we picked 1, so it's 3, 5, and 8. Okay, if we pick 5, because 5 is the third number, we are picking 5. So from that we get 40, and we still have the 3 numbers, 3, 1, and 8. And if we pick 8, so for that also we got 40, and the remaining numbers are 3, 1, and 5. Okay. Now, what we have to do is we have to maximize the number of points we can make. So what we are going to do is whatever the answer we get from these 4 calls, we are going to take a max of that. So let's further drill down this tree, recursion tree, and see like how can we achieve 167. So this call again, if we pick 1, so this will have, again, imagine that at the ends of the array, you have 1 and 1. Okay. So if we pick 1, we get 5. So this again can make 3 subtrees where 1 will be, so first will be for 1, we will have 5 plus 2 calls for the remaining numbers. So we have busted 1. So 5 and 8 are remaining. If we pick 5, then we have 8, because 8 into 5 into 1. Okay. So if we pick 1, the answer will be 5, because 1 into 1 into 5 is 5. If we pick 5, then the answer is 40 here. So let's make this 40 and the remaining of the numbers in the arrays. So those are 1 and 8. So we say 1 and 8. Now, if we pick 8, then also we get 40. So here we will be remaining with 1 and 5. Okay. So now, if we again drill down this, so again, now we have 5 and 8. So either we can pick 5. So if we pick 5, the points will be 40, because 8 multiplied by 5 multiplied by the hidden ones on the side. Okay. Yeah. So this will be 40. If we pick 8 also, then also the answer will be 40. So just for the clarification, let's draw the tree. So if we pick 5, we have 40 left and plus, and 8 is the remaining bulb. And if we pick 8, then also we have 40, because 8 multiplied by 1 multiplied by 5 is 40, plus the remaining balloon is 5. Okay. Now for this, since we have only one element left now, so this, for this the answer will be the same number. So for this 8, for this 5. Okay. Now let's go back. So this returns 5, and this will again be 5 now. So 40 plus 5 is 45. So 40 plus 5 is 45. For this, this returns 8. So let's say this returns 8. 8, and 40 plus 8 is 48. 48. So this is what this column returns. So now what we said? We said that we are going to take a max of the subrecursive calls. So out of 48 and 45, the max will be 48. So we take a max. So here, if we say, we can say this and this, we take a max equal to 48, which will be returned here. So this call now returns 48, right? Now, before going back, let's evaluate this one. So we had, after choosing 5, we had 40 here. So for these two, let's go and see. We can either pick 1 or we can pick 8. So if we pick 1, then our subtrees will be 1 into 8 into 1, which is 8, plus, since we have picked 1, 8 is the last number which is remaining. If we pick 8, then also 8 into 1 into 1. So this makes 8 again, plus 1 is the remaining number. Okay. Now here, if you again go back, drill down further, this returns 8. So 8 plus 8, 16 will be returned here. And 8 plus 1, 9 will be returned. Okay. And out of 16 and 9, the max is 16. So for this, let's keep the answer as 16. Now similarly for this tree, you can do, you can pick 1. If you pick 1, we will have 5 plus what is the remaining number? 1. If you pick 5, then also you have 5. If you pick 1, then you have remaining number as 5. Sorry. If you pick 5, then you have this 5 here, because 5 multiplied by 1 multiplied by 1 is 5. Plus, since you pick 5, the only number remaining is 1. So out of these two recursive calls, this will return 5 again. So we can add 5 here to this number, and this will return 1. So we can add 1 here. So 5 plus 1 is 6 here, and 5 plus 5 is 10 here. So out of 10 and 6, we have 10 as the maximum number. Okay. So now, again, we can add 5 and 48. This will be 53. We can add 40 and 16. This will be 56. And we can add 40 and 10. And this will be 50. So out of this, again, we will pick the max, which is this guy. So 40 plus 16 is 56. So this call returns 56. Now we have to solve the recursion tree for the remaining of the calls. So let's go down the remaining calls also very patiently. So now we again know that this is going to give chances to 3 recursive calls. This is also going to give chances for 3 recursive calls. And this is also going to give chances for 3 recursive calls. I will try to fit all this recursion tree in one page. So let's go down this one. So we pick 3. And if you are picking 3, the points we gain here from this are 15. So let me write 15. And plus the remaining numbers. So the remaining numbers are 5 and 8. So 5 and 8. If we pick 5, then we have 40 here. If we pick 5, then what is the number we are having here? So 8 into 5 into 3, and that's 40 into 3, that's 120. And the remaining numbers are 8 and 5, 8 and 3. So let's keep 8 and 3 here. Similarly, if we pick 8, then also 120, and the remaining numbers are 3 and 5. Okay. Now let's also draw a recursion tree for this call. So we will solve all of them one by one. So this, for this, I think this will be 3 plus, so for 3, this will be 3 into 1 into 1, which is 3, plus the remaining numbers are 1 and 8, If we pick 1, then 8 into 1 into 3 is 24, and remaining numbers are 8 and 3. So 8 and 3. And if we pick 8, then also this is 24, this is 8 into 1 into 1, which is 8 into 1 into 1 is 8. And the remaining numbers are 3 and 1. So 3 and 1. I think here when we picked 8, this should be 40, not 120. So let me correct this. This will be 40. Okay. Now, if you see that we are repeating some problems here, like if you see 5 and 8 was here as well, and 5 and 8 was here as well. 1 and 8 was here, 1 and 8 is here also. And similarly, you see there are some repeated subproblems. So for the subproblems, I'm just going to reuse the solution which I calculated above, because the recursion tree is going to be same. So for this subproblem, 5 and 8, we know that the answer is 48. So just let me write 48 here. For 8 and 3, do we have a problem which is already solved? No, we don't have. For 8 and 3, what we can do is we can quickly calculate. So if you just keep drawing the recursion tree like this, so for 8 and 3, it will become, if we pick 8, we have 24 plus only 3 is remaining. If we pick 3, then we have 24 plus 8 is remaining. So now, in this case, the answer will be 24 plus 8, because we have to take the max of these two values. So 24 plus 8 will be 32. So here, let's keep 32. For 3 and 5, do we have a solution? No. For 3 and 5, if you again pick something, so if you pick 3, you have 15 plus 5 remaining. If you pick 5, then you have 15 plus 3 remaining. Okay, so now in this case, you will have 20 from here and 18 from here. So out of these, we will again pick a max. So we will return 20 here. So 20. Now, so 15 plus 48, this will be 58 and 63. So this will return 63. 120 plus 32, this will be 162. Not 162, it's 152. So 152. And 40 plus 20, this will be 60. Now here again going by, for 1 and 8, we already have the solution, it's 16. So let's write 16 here. For 8 and 3, we already have solution 32. So let's write 32 for this guy. And for 3 and 1, do we have the solution? No, we haven't gone through that subproblem yet. So for 3 and 1, if we pick 3, we have 3 points. And if we pick 1, 1 will be the remaining number. So 1 here. If we pick 1, then also we have 3 points, and 3 will be the remaining number. So out of these two, again, we have to take max. So this will return 6. So 3 plus 16 is 19. 24 plus 32 is 20 and 30, 52 and 4, 6. So 56 here. And 8 plus 6 will be 14. So 14 for this guy. Now our last top level recursion tree, this is okay. So if we pick 3, then we have 3 points here, and remaining balloons are 1 and 5. Do we have a solution for 1 and 5? Yes, we have. It's 10. You can see from here. So let's write 10 here. And we can pick 1. So if we pick 1, we have 15 points. So just remember that whenever we pick, we are multiplying the numbers which are on the left and on the right and in the between. So for if we pick 1, then we have the answer 15. And since we have picked 1, the remaining subset is 3, 5. Do we have an answer for 3, 5? Yes, we have. It's 20. So let's write 20 over here. And then if we pick 5, so again, this will be 15. No, not 15. This will be 5, because 1 into 5 into 1. And we have the remaining number 3 and 1. Do we have a solution for 3 and 1? Yes, we have. And it's 6, 3 and 1. So now again, 5 plus 6, 11, 15 plus 20, this will be 35, So 35 and 3 plus 10, 13. So out of these three, we are taking the max, which is 35. So we return 35 here. Out of these three, we return the max. So this gets 56. Out of these three also, we have to return the max. So 63, 152, and 60. This is 152. And at the end, out of these three also, we need to take the max. So let's add quickly. So 5 plus 48, 40 plus 16, 56. Okay, we have already done this, and this has returned 56. Okay. So now, finally, if you see, 3 plus 56 is 59. 15 plus 152 is 167. So this yields 167. And 40 plus 56, this gives 96. And 40 plus, okay, so this returns 35. So 40 plus 35, this gives 75. So again, we have to take max. So if we take max of 59, 167, 96, and 75. So the answer is going to be 167. So if you look at the lead code's answer, this is 167, and this is how we calculated the solution. So we are going to take a max here. Let me write max. Now this process, the way we tried to figure out the solution for this problem was the brute force scenario. And as you all know, that brute force scenario is not good. And there were a couple of sub-problems which were encountered. But even if you try to solve it using that, so if you see that at every point, like how do we calculate the time complexity for this solution? So let me write time complexity. So if you have watched my previous videos for time complexity, I have told you that for recursive problems, it's number of choices you have at the point and to the power of the depth of your recursion tree, right? So here, if you see that, how many choices do you have at every single point? Like when you were at 3, right? How many choices did you have? You have 2 choices, right? So how many choices did we have? So the choices were 2. What were the choices? Choices were 2. What were the choices? The first choice was to burst the balloon. We picked the balloon and we burst the balloon. The second choice was to burst the balloon at a later point in time. So 2 choices. Now we know that we are having 2 choices. Okay. Now if you have a look at the recursion tree, right? So you see that at every point in the recursion tree, we are decreasing the problem size by 1. So this means that we will have to go to the height of the tree for this problem will be equal to the size of the array. So if you see, the array was of size 4, and this is the first level, this is the second level, this is the third level, and this is the final level. So there were 4 levels in this recursion tree. So choices to the power of number of levels. So number of levels is equal to the length of the array, right? Now, this is not the only part. We have to do this for every single element. Like we can start bursting the balloons at any point. So we can start with 3, we can start with 1, we can start with 5, and we can start with 8. So for each and every of those possibilities, we will have to do this much work, which is 2^n. So for each element, if we try to do this, this is going to be the time complexity for the solution, which is n into 2^n. Let me write it again. N into 2^n. So in this video, we saw how to draw the naive recursion tree for the burst balloons problems. And in the next video, we are going to see an optimal solution for this problem and how we can draw the dynamic programming recursion tree, how we can solve this problem using bottom-up approach, and what is it that we are going to do when we want to reduce the time complexity for this problem. Okay. So if you like this video, please subscribe to the channel. If you have any queries, you can put it in the comments. Otherwise, see you later. Bye.